Scoot up for a second and let's talk. Yo, DJ, roll that beautiful champagne footage. Welcome to Champagne Secrezz, where the bubbles are crisp, the secrets are smoother than silk, and the gossip flows like the finest champagne.
Big up yourself, Empress. Glasses up to the streets that never sleep. And to the secrets running deep, let's get it.
Champagne Secrezz. Welcome, my loves, my beauties and beaus, to the Chalei, located in Champagne City, baby. You see it, you see it. Come join me, the Empress, for some grown discussions and bubbly banter. Over here, we get classy with a twist, huh? A little clink with chaos with a side of charm. So if you're ready to sip, savor, and spill, then come on in. And if you're a non-alcoholic kind of confidant, grab you a non-alcoholic bubbly and get in here. And if you're joining us in the morning, throw you some orange juice in and make it a mimosa. It's all good. Tell your friends about us and consider becoming a confidant yourself. Go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button so you'll be notified when we jump into the Chalei for another show. As for what I'm sipping on, I am sipping on my Moet and Chandon Imperial Rosé. Remember, over here, we think and drink responsibly. Now take those glasses and raise them high in the air. It is time for our positivity and affirmations. Are y'all ready? Let's go. I am a radiant being, full of endless possibilities and joy. I am the architect of my life. I build its foundation and choose its contents. I am a magnet for miracles, and I attract only good things into my life. I am fearless in the pursuit of what sets my soul on fire. So cheers to you, confidants, for you are worth it. Didn't that feel good? The more positivity you add to your life, the more positivity you'll draw to your life, and the less mess you'll have time to be entangled in.
So y'all, here's my real question, right? How did we go from this?
From Television City in Hollywood.
Go from that to this.
I have important news.
Let me guess. The state called and they want to cut you a disability check for your face.
Hold up. You can get paid for that?
This is from a fool who stares at his orange juice every morning.
It says concentrate on the box. Who the dummy now?
Shit. Me for not wearing a condom.
Shadows fall over my heart.
It all started
with my grandfather, James Evans. My job as the man of this house is to take care of this family no matter what.
I just want to let you know I'm going to take good care of Gray.
Gray, who is this I'm about to kill?
Juan, my boyfriend. Daddy, let him go.
Maybe you should come with me.
Junior's repeating the 10th grade for the third time.
Is there anything you can suggest to help him get to the drive-thru?
Can you do OnlyFans? Take off your shoes. Let me see what kind of feet you're working with.
To the dark side.
Dear Black Heavenly Father, College Redeemer, if you could just help us.
Son, it's for you.
New phone, who this?
Black everything.
At least they ain't got that drug dealing baby under my roof no more.
Man, my mouth ready for some milk right now.
Dalvin, why are you so breast obsessed? It's childish, man.
Bruh, I'm a baby. I can't get no more childish than that. in a nocturnal state of mind.
Your neighborhood is a real shithole.
It's the system. They put the guns and drugs on the streets.
Underneath this black, black sky.
This is getting dangerous. I won't just sit back and let you put yourself in harm's way. I love you too damn much.
Everything black.
The revolution will not be televised.
Come on, Rosa Parks, can't you just enjoy this?
We're just as good as the Evans of old.
Isn't that just dynamite?
But the truth is, we're the Evans of new.
First of all, y'all, let me start off by saying this, right? All of the clips used were done so in accordance with the Fair Use Act that allows so for the use of teaching, discussion, criticism, and entertainment. But who authorized this? Like, for real, whose bright idea was it to take an iconic show like Good Times and diminish it to this? Good Times was a show that took real life situations that poor black people were dealing with and taught real life lessons from them. It showed a black man, a strong black man, working hard to provide for his family and be the man of the house for his family with limited means, may I add, while teaching his children lessons about responsibility and family. This show, if some of you did not know, was actually a spinoff of a show named Maude, where Florida was Maude's housekeeper and her husband, named Henry in Maude, was a firefighter. And that show was a spinoff of All in the Family, where this bigoted, prejudiced, old Caucasian man who didn't seem to like nobody, but the show tackled issues like racism and women's rights, which was really crazy because black people ate this show up. We did. We loved the hell out of this show. We watched it and we even laughed because shows back then had substance. They had meaning. They had purpose. What substance does this have? Someone please tell me. And then you name it after an iconic, timeless show like Good Times.
If I only had a brain.
Because who thought of this? Like, for real. The bigger problem is, why did they think we would want it? This show wasn't created for white America. It was created for us because they thought this is what we wanted. Yeah. See, they see our response to the Boondocks with this disrespectful ass little boy that you can't tell nothing, to how we respond to GTA and how our children respond, where there's nothing going on but robbing and stealing and essaying, and our kids are playing this, and our kids will be the ones who will be watching this because they don't know what Good Times stood for. Who do you think this show was geared toward? Do you think it was really geared towards adults? No, cartoons are geared towards children because cartoons capture children's attention. They're geared towards force-feeding down our children's throats and imprinting on them the stereotypes to aspire to. This show tells children that's who they are. That's who we are. Not only that, but it also tells other cultures that this is who we are. This wasn't geared towards adults. It just so happens adults still like cartoons, so we get into them. These shows leave impressions on our children. If you don't think they do, why do you have to create a Batman room for your son? A Barbie room for your daughter? Why did you want to be your favorite superhero for Halloween? Because you watched a show and it left an impression. What kind of impression are you leaving with this? Not to mention that in order to take their own show, Good Times, the actual show, they had to step down from middle class, from being a middle class family, to an impoverished one living in the projects, to be further degraded down to this. Come on, man. This show here is sensationalizing nigga shit. I said it. They think we all want to get rich or die trying. A drug dealing baby, huh? Come on, y'all. Really? So the consensus is, right, that in the hood, we're so thirsty to be hood rich that even our kids are drug dealers. Our babies are menaces too, right? And guess who in the show our impressionable children are going to want to be? The hype drug dealing baby, right? The even crazier part is, if it weren't for the fact that they named it Good Times, as if guns and drug dealing is the good time in the hood, as if a baby being shot at is a laughable matter when you have babies losing their lives over gun violence daily. Not only that, but a drug dealing baby objectifying women. During a time when we have all of this Epstein and Diddy-ish going on, you would release a cartoon that shows a baby with a grown man voice objectifying a woman.
If I only had a brain.
If it weren't for the name, the show would have been accepted. Because they know this is what we like, hood toxic-ish. So they're going to keep pumping it out as long as all of the shows that we produce have guns and strippers and shooting and sex, because I know y'all saw that silhouette in the preview, right? And BBLs and violence. What do you think they're going to continue to throw at us, telling us about who we think or who they think we really are? But we don't get it. We don't get it because that's what brings in all the money. The toxic hood-ish is what we go for. And somewhere in a boardroom, Netflix said, oh yeah, that's an amazing idea. They're gonna eat this one up. I have an idea for Netflix, for all of the rest of the shows. Why not show the new generation making it out of the hood, right? If you wanted to show, if you wanted to call the show Good Times, why not show the family, the descendants of the original, finally making out of the hood? That would be Good Times. Show them owning houses, hair salons, corporations, teaching their children to do the same. Show them building generational wealth. Why does this group that they're showing here, why does that define the whole? Because this is not okay. And if you don't see a problem with this, I'm sorry to say, you're part of the problem with this. When are we, as a people, going to demand a better representation of us on TV? Because this ain't it. We have got to figure out how to change the narrative. Our children's lives depend on it. That's all I have for this one. Why don't you drop in the comments and let me know what you think about today's show? While you're at it, please consider becoming a confidant. Hit that like and subscribe button. Also consider supporting the channel. The Cash App is on the screen. I am not yet monetized, but everything that you see, the design of the thumbnails to the videos, I create it all. All proceeds that you may send go to either helping my son, who is autistic and he's a D1 ball player, to helping my daughter, who, if you watch my recent video on the loss of my grandchild, recently lost her child while she was pregnant. So I'm doing what I can to try to assist her. So anything that you send will go to supporting them too. So please consider supporting the channel by sending something to Cash App. And if not, your like, your listen, your subscribe, and your comment is enough. Thank you so much. Confidants, always remember, if it doesn't cause you to elevate, it's causing you to depreciate. Now raise those glasses, clink, and let's drink till we meet again. Ta-ta.